We are under the lights this evening as we get you set for another edition of Baseball on the Show. Tonight, we've got a good matchup in store between the Atlanta Braves and the Arizona Diamondbacks. And that'll bring in the former top prospect, Ozzie Albies. He'll get us started in this one under the lights. And a good pitch there as this is swung on and missed for the first out of the ball game. The next to bat for Atlanta, Nick Markakis. Markakis ahead with a 3-1 count here. Line hard to the left side, but this is a foul ball. And we could be in for a cold one tonight. 52 degrees at game time, but should see the 40s before we're through. Swing and a miss on the changeup, and there are two gone.
Batting third, the first baseman, number 5, Freddie Freeman.
Can't keep the weight back, and he falls behind 1-2. Back to the fastball, but it's upstairs. Two balls and two strikes now. And good patience to hold back on the curveball in the dirt. It's full now, 3-2.
If you're at the plate right now, you have to realize who's on deck. I guarantee you something's wrong.
Well, the play's been made, and that retires the side. Here's Starling Marte. He'll lead things off here in the bottom half of the first. Now the 2-1 pitch. Strike two swinging. Hit out towards second. Albies brings it in, and he will whip this one over to first in time for the out. So one away here with the bases empty, and that means that Nick Ahmed will be the next to bat. 1-1 is taken for ball two. Line drive base hit. Into the box now, Ketel Marte, fouled off. And he fouls this one off. Ahmed stands at first with one out. High in the air out to center field. Acuna's there for it. He's got it, and there are two down now. So it's a runner at first with two gone. And up next, the outfielder, David Peralta. Two balls and a strike. Lifted in the air to center. Acuna will get there, and he puts it away to retire the side. Acuna digs in now. He went hitless last night in a game where his guys could push across only one score. The 3-2 pitch. And it's fouled away. Count still full, 3-2. And that misses for ball four, so it's a leadoff walk here to start the second. Here's Marcelo Zuna looking for better results than last night when he went 0-for-4 in that one. In the dirt. And it's not in time as he's in well ahead of the throw. And forget about the double play now as he'll move up to second here on the wild pitch. set and the 2-1 pitch.
They know the threat this guy possesses at the plate. I know it's 3-1 in this situation right here, but I can't imagine anything comes over the heart of the plate.
And he lays off there, ball four. So back-to-back walks have him in business here with nobody out.
That is good.
Here now is the catcher, Tyler Flowers.
Wow.
1-1. Swung on and missed for strike number two. And the knuckle curve freezes him as he becomes out number one. Digging in, Charlie Culberson comes off an 0 for 4 in last night's ball game. And that misses 2-1.
Great chance right here as a hitter to be really aggressive. With two guys already on, pretty good shot. He's going to get a challenge pitch right here.
Three balls and a strike to the Atlanta shortstop. Boy, not close again. His third walk of the inning as that misses for ball four. Standing in now with runners in scoring position, Austin Riley. And he could give his guys an early lead if he can come through here. Grounder down the line at third. But this will get foul, so they'll do it again. 3-2. Another full count pitch on its way. Count remains full. No score here as we play inning number two. Turned on that one and crushed it. Just pulled it a little foul. High in the air out towards shallow right. Marte has it, and I'd be surprised if they send the runner. So our situation is the bases loaded, two men out, and that'll leave things up to Cole Hamels, the pitcher. Ready with the 1-1. Just behind the fastball there, two strikes now.
Hey, this is a huge pitch right here. It would be demoralizing to watch this inning slip away.
Now a fastball awfully close, but he doesn't get the call. It's 2-2 now.
Well, two straight fastballs inside haven't put him away, so now it'll be interesting.
A swing and a miss. That retires the side, and that will do it. So here's Eduardo Escobar. Took an 0 for 4 in the victory last night. Drilled to the right side. And this will get through into right, and he's aboard with a single. To the plate now, Carson Kelly. On the ground is short. This could be two. Fielded cleanly over to Albies. On to Freeman, a double play. Digging in, Christian Walker will try to make something happen with two gone in the bottom of the second. One, two is the cut fastball, but he holds back 2-2. Look out. Don't want to hit him there. It's full 3-2.
You know, we'll see him work both sides of the plate with his curveball. Maybe not that far in, but he'll move that pitch around the zone to give it a different look.
And he lost him here on 3-2 as that pitch misses. It's ball four. The 1-2. Is swung on and missed, strike three. Top of the third set to get underway, so up steps Ozzie Albies. He was a strikeout victim in his first try. Swing and a miss as he starts the third the same way he ended the second, with a punch out, one away.
How about it?
So one gone for the Braves here in the third. And standing in, the powerful right fielder, Nick Markakis. 1-2 now as that one's fouled off. Swung on and lifted in the air to left center. After it is Peralta. He tracks it down and makes the play to record the second out. So bases are empty here with two gone. And into bat next, one of the best run producers in the game, the left-handed hitting first baseman, Freddie Freeman. Fly ball to straightaway left. Peralta's after it. A dive, and he brings it in. And on a fantastic play, the inning is over. Next to hit will be the pitcher, Zach Gallen. He'll lead it off here against Cole Hamels. Ready with the 1-1 pitch.
You certainly know he's not trying to work around the pitcher. Sometimes the hardest thing to do is to throw a strike to a guy that you know won't swing the bat.
Count even at 2-2. Liner towards second. And the pitcher's got himself a base hit.
The right fielder, number two, Starling.
In now, Starling Marte hit the other way out toward right field. Marcakis has a read on it, one down. Coming to the plate now, Nick Ahmed. He reached on a single in his first try. Hamels ready with the 1-1. Bottom of inning number three, nothing our score. Now a fastball taken outside here as it moves it to 2-2 now. Liner in there for a base hit. And that runner will go no further than second as there are two aboard now.
Now back, center fielder, Cattell.
At the plate now, Cattell Marte. Hey. This is chopped down the third baseline. But this will be a foul ball as that evens things at 2-2. And another foul ball. First and second now, one man out. Heading out towards shallow right. Marcakis is coming on. He gets there, and that's the second out. So here's the cleanup hitter, David Peralta, 0-for-1 here in the early going. Good location on the outside corner there, 1-2. Driven the other way, but caught down at third. Almost big trouble there, but he'll wind up stranding two as the side is retired. Stepping in for the Braves, Ronald Acuna. He drew a walk his first time up.
This game is rolling right along as we move into the middle innings with no score. You'd think by now one of these two teams would be able to get some base runners on and get him in, but that hasn't been the case.
Now a curveball here, nowhere close. That's in the dirt. It's 3-1. Still all zeros in the run column here in the fourth inning. And does this continue or does somebody score here?
I think this continues for a while, Matt. Both of these pitchers are throwing very well, throwing strikes, having good command of their off-speed pitches. This is going to be one of those low-scoring affairs.
Fastball swung on and missed for the first out.
Up next for Atlanta, the left fielder, Marcel.
The 2-1 home. Got him to swing on top of that one as this ball's dribbled out in front of the mound. And there are two away now. Digging in to try it again, Tyler Flowers comes into this at bat 0-for-1 in the ball game. Two balls and a strike. Here it comes. This is in the air to center. Does he have another 1-2-3 for the Ledger? He does. 8 in a row he's set down, and the side is retired. Eduardo Escobar standing in. The 1-1 home. Swung on and missed, and that's strike two.
Made him look silly with that one.
Fly ball out toward left center field. Ozuna giving chase, and he tracks it down. Nice play for the first down. Now with the play, Christian Kelly. He's 0-for-1 thus far. Pitching has the upper hand early as we're scoreless in inning number 4. Skied into straightaway right. Markakis has a read on it. And he brings it in for the second out of the inning. Into the box now, Christian Walker. No runs, 4 hits. No errors so far for the Diamondbacks. Now a little dribbler here off to the right side of the mound. Throw on to first, gets him, and the side is retired. Now at the plate, Charlie Culberson. He'll start off the 5th in this one.
We're moving through the middle of this ball game right now. If they want to get things going, how about trying to get some base runners on, or at least get a base hit? They don't have any hits going into this part of the game.
3-2 pitch. Now a ball hit foul off to the right and up into the crowd. The next 3-2. Skied into straightaway right. Marte is under it. One down. Stepping in and ready for another shot, Austin Riley. 0-for-1 for him here in this one. The 2-2 is swung on and missed. He got him. Settling in now, Cole Hamels. This guy is still looking at a 0 in the hit column. From the windup, the 1-1 pitch.
Ball, no. Two balls, one strike.
Fouled away.
Ball three.
So a full count now.
Well, he really needs to make this guy swing the bat right here. He's not the type of hitter you want to dance around with.
Fouled off. Braves are still looking to break into the hit column here. Too close for comfort, and he did a good job just to make contact. High in the air out towards shallow right. And he'll get there in plenty of time to put this one away, and that ends the inning. Up next for Arizona, Ildemaro Vargas. He'll look to bounce back after striking out his last time up.
Sometimes you just got to tip your cap to the guy on the mound. He's getting paid to try and get you out as well. Anytime it gets up there north of 7-8 pitch ABs, sometimes it just comes down to pure execution. Let's see if he makes the adjustment right here.
And that misses ball 4 now. It's a leadoff walk to get the home half of the 5th underway. Now a bunt attempt here. And they'll put the tag on him going to first, but the sacrifice is successful. Now back to the top of the lineup, stepping in, Starling Marte. He flew out in his last at bat. And that misses ball 4, so it's first and second now with only one away. Standing in, Nick Ahmed. 2 hits in 2 trips for him thus far. And the pitch on 2-1. Back up the middle, reined in. Freeman at first, and there are 2 away now. So 2 on with 2 away. That'll bring up the infielder, Ketel Marte. Next pitch from Hamels tonight will be number 73 for him in the ballgame. Fastball misses in the dirt as he tried to get him to chase the low one.
2-1.
Easy there, big fella. 2-2.
Definitely a big pitch coming up right here. He's going to be pumped if he can work his way out of this inning with the game still tied.
Fastball is outside. It's full now. 3-2.
He's already walked two in this inning already. This guy just can't seem to find the strike zone.
Swing and a liner, but foul. He sent the 3-2. Hit on the ground to third. On to first, and the Diamondbacks are turned away as the inning is over. Now batting, Ozzie Albies. He's set to lead us off in the sixth inning. The 1-1. The 1-2. Misses, ball two. Skied in the air to straightaway left. Peralta is there, and he has it for the out. Here's Nick Markakis now, the right fielder. He's 0 for 2 with a strikeout in this one. Markakis. High in the air down the right field line. Marte is over, and he puts it away in foul ground for the second out. Here's the first baseman, Freddie Freeman. He comes in 0 for 2 thus far. No runs, no hits, and no errors so far for Atlanta. Two balls and a strike to Freeman.
Two balls, one strike.
Yanked on the ground down the line. A dive, and oh, he can't hang on. The flip to the pitcher covering, as that will retire the side. So striding forward now, David Peralta. He'll be the first to swing it here in the Arizona sixth inning. Into the windup, here comes the 2-2 pitch. This is well struck, high and deep toward the left field corner. This is going to kick off the fence now out in front of the Arizona bullpen. And he'll get there as the Diamondbacks get a man into scoring position on the leadoff double. Standing in now, Eduardo Escobar. Now a changeup locks him up as he looks at strike three called, one away. Now in the box, Carson Kelly. It was a flyout for him in his last trip. 1-1. Hit fairly well out towards straightaway center. Acuna's there for it. He's got it, and there are two down now. And no tag at second. He'll head back there with two away now. Digging in once again, Christian Walker. Runner in scoring position with two gone. This one runs a little too far in, ball two. And there's a base hit on the line. The run comes across to score, and they jump ahead 1-0. Shane Green is out from the bullpen now as he'll make his first appearance here on the season. Into the box, Ildemaro Vargas. Fastball, and it gets by him, a swinging strike. Green rarely finds himself in much trouble out of the bullpen, at least in terms of giving up base hits. He's proven to be a tough guy to barrel up. The flip to the pitcher covering, as that will retire the side. Here's Ronald Acuna Jr. now, and he'll get us started in what's officially the back third of this one.
This thing's far from over, even though we're moving into the back end of this game. Only down by one. All they need to do is get this leadoff guy, and they're an extra base hit away from tying this thing up.
On the ground, up the middle. Oh, look at him, man. To first. He beat it out. He did everything he could do to keep the no-hitter going, but that base hit ends the bid for history. Into the box now, Marcelo Zuna. Two and one.
Very impressive outing so far. His command has been spot on. Even when he misses his spot, it isn't out over the heart of the plate. He's throwing quality pitches.
Smoked on the ground up the middle. Marte gloves it. Stepping in now, Tyler Flowers. Into the corner and slicing foul.
The Braves have been looking for that big hit pretty much all game. It remains to be seen if they can get it, but now sure would be a big time for that.
Two balls and two strikes now to the Braves catcher. The 2-2 is laid off and the count runs full.
One of the things you want to do with a starter, get that pitch count up. Here's another productive at bat as this count now gets to three balls and two strikes.
It's a high fly ball headed for the left field corner. If it stays fair, it's gone. And that nearly would have gotten him on the board. Instead, it's a long foul ball. Another full count pitch home. Is in there, called strike three. Stefan Crichton will come on to pitch now as he'll move into the eighth spot in the lineup on the double switch here. Tim LoCastro is into the ball game as well as he'll slide into the pitcher's spot, hitting ninth now on the double switch.
Now pitching and batting in the eighth spot, number 58, Stefan.
On the run, this one in on him, and he can't connect, so he finds himself down one and two now.
In a big spot like this, you have to be looking for something you can handle. That pitch bunched him up completely, so I think he's...
This ball gets down. Let's see if they try to score. And the tying run comes around to score from second. It's one to one.
Now that, number 27.
So now to the plate, Austin Riley. And there's ball two now. A swing and he pops him up on the infield. And the infield fly rule will be in effect here. Ender Inciarte will come on to pinch hit here in a big spot.
Number 11, Ender.
Two men are on with two men out. Two and one now. Looking at his lifetime numbers, Inciarte is slugging a little under the 400 mark, so the chances of his connecting with the ball right here aren't particularly good. Close there, but he doesn't get the call with the breaking ball.
When you're playing close games like this, base runners mean everything, so he can ill afford to start giving away free passes.
Full count to Ender Inciarte, three balls and two strikes.
That pitch looked like it could have been a little high, but he's been calling that pitch all night. Kind of rough for a pinch hitter, but I'm sure his teammates let him know that's where the zone has been.
Marte's after it. And he brings it down to end the inning as the go-ahead run is left stranded. Luke Jackson gets the call from the pen to take over on the mound and start the home seventh. Ready now, Tim LoCastro. He's newly entered into the ballgame, so this will be his first trip to the plate here in inning number seven. Here's a fly ball, well hit. And this is going to get down for what should be extra bases, and there's your potential go-ahead run. And he will make it in safely. He's in at third as the go-ahead run.
The right fielder, number two.
To the plate now, Starling Marte. Lined but speared on a hop. And he'll step on first himself for the out. So coming to the plate, Nick Ahmed in his career against this pitcher, batting at an even 400. Three balls and a strike to count to the Diamondbacks shortstop.
Boy, this is a dicey situation right here, D-Row, with the runner in scoring position. The sac fly brings that run in. This is where you're going to really have to try to keep the ball on the ground as a pitcher. What do you want to do as a hitter, D-Row?
Yeah, right here, you are looking for anything above the belt. You see it up, you have to let it go. This is where you have to check your ego at the door. Something has to be elevated and put into the outfield. Give your team a chance to score a run.
Good battle. Count remains full. Just hung in there on that one. Go-ahead runs in scoring position here with one away. Neither guy giving in here, and they'll do it again. The next 3-2. And there's ball four as this one gets away a bit. At the plate, Ketel Marte. And their runners at the corners now. Here it comes on 1-1. Swing and a line drive into left field, a base hit. Coming in to score is the runner from third, and they've taken the lead here in the seventh.
Now back, no left fielder, Denver.
At the plate, David Peralta. And he takes one off the inside corner for ball two.
His pitch count is getting up there in the inning now. He needs to get this frame over with sooner than later, so forcing contact and getting the defense involved is probably the best thing he can do.
3-1 to the Diamondbacks left fielder. The 3-1. He is swung on and missed. A full count now.
Not much you're going to do with that pitch right there. You have to catch it out front before it even breaks, and even if you do that, it's a tough pitch to keep fair.
Now the 3-2 pitch. That's lifted the other way out to left. Ozuna will get there with ease as he puts it away for out number two. Ready now for the Diamondbacks. Eduardo Escobar. Two outs and two runners aboard here in the seventh inning.
Escobar.
He's set. The 3-1. Hit down the third baseline. And the throw to first is in time, but the damage has been done as the side is retired. Hector Rondon has been summoned from the bullpen as he'll do so to start the eighth.
Number 28, Hector.
Ball set for the start of the inning. Digging in the switch hitter, Ozzie Albies. He's hitless in three at-bats to this point. Lifted down the line in left, and that will end up a foul ball. Struck him out again, his third punch out of the game. Nick Markakis digging in now. It was a flyout for him in his last trip, and he lays off ball four. So now the potential tying run here is aboard late in the game. Time called here, as with the potential tying run aboard, they'll make the move to get a little more speed out there. So a runner at first now with one away, and that brings in Freddie Freeman. Now a ball grounded foul over toward the coaching box. The 1-2. Now he goes the other way, and he got a lot of it high and deep to left center field. It's gone. They've taken the lead in the eighth. Kevin Ginkle is out from the bullpen now as he'll make his first appearance here on the season.
Number 37, Kevin Ginkle.
In now, Ronald Acuna. And now a good slider that doesn't quite catch the zone. It's 2-1 now. Skied in the air to straightaway left. Peralta is under it. And he brings it in for the second out of the inning. And that'll bring in Marcelo Zuna. He's working on a 1-for-2 game so far. Set. Here comes the 1-1. shin high. That's taken for a ball. This is hit high in the air out toward left center. Long run for the center fielder. He tracks it down, and that will end the inning. Darren O'Day is on to pitch out of the bullpen in the bottom half of the eighth. Bottom of inning number eight set to go. Ready for another shot now. Carson Kelly, he could really use a knock here. 0 for 3 in the game so far. A two ball, two strike count to the Diamondbacks catcher. O'Day has tossed more than 500 innings at the big league level. And in that time, he's allowed just barely over a base runner per inning, which of course is very good. And a good sinker there gets him swinging for the first out. Stepping up to the plate, Christian Walker. He came through with an RBI single in his last at bat. The 1-2 pitch. And he strikes him out as well. So make it back to back punch outs here to the first two men he faces out of the bullpen. Three and two now.
Three balls, two strikes, the count is four.
And he lays off ball four. So now the potential tying run here is aboard late in the game.
Now back.
So a crucial moment here, and standing in, Tim LoCastro. And he does so representing the possible go-ahead run. The 1-2.
Man, this at bat has changed quickly from 0-2 now to 2-2. A good job of plate discipline by this hitter, not chasing those pitches just off the plate.
Good swing on a tough pitch, and he'll stick around to see another one.
Oh, that's frustrating right there. He was right on that fastball, took it deep, just couldn't keep it fair. How many times have you seen it? There's a good chance he's punching out right here.
And as it turns out, the two-out walk doesn't come around to haunt him as that ends the inning. Archie Bradley enters from the pen to start the ninth inning as he'll try to keep the score right where it is heading to the bottom of the ninth. Riding in once again, Tyler Flowers. 0 for 3 with a couple of strikeouts for him to this point in the ballgame. 2-1. And he gets under this one a bit as this is lifted into center field. Marte is right there, one down. Digging in, Charlie Culberson. He singled his last time up. The 3-1. Is in there for a full count now, 3-2.
Full count.
Still hanging with him, another good swing to keep it going. The 3-2, one more time. He is swung on and missed. He got him on strikes. Stepping in, Austin Riley. No hits in three tries so far. He struck out once. Now the 2-1. Hit the other way out toward right field. Marte is under it. And the inning is over. Will Smith enters the game to finish this one off here in the bottom of the ninth.
Now pitching and batting in the seventh.
Back to the top spot in the Arizona lineup now, and stepping in, Starling Marte. He was a ground out victim last time up.
Hey, it's never easy scoring runs against a closer, but this lineup is setting up perfectly right now as the leadoff hitter leads off this inning.
And a 3-2 full count to Starling Marte. Swing and a miss, and that'll get a groan from the home supporters here. One away. Coming to the plate now, Nick Ahmed. He's 2-for-3 thus far. The 1-2. Pulls this one in the air out to left. Ozuna is under it. Two gone. Into the box now, Ketel Marte. It was an RBI single for him in his last plate appearance. The 1-1 is a fastball that misses. Smith, a former San Francisco Giant, he was acquired via trade last year.
Yeah, this guy's fully settled in with this ball club right now. Knows what the manager and coaching staff expect from him. Is not taken aback by anything. He's been through the spring training process and gotten to know everybody in this organization top to bottom.
And he fouls this one off. Arizona down to its last strike. And good patience to hold back on the curveball in the dirt. It's full now, 3-2.
Time to narrow your focus up there at the plate. In a one-run game, he doesn't want to walk it, so there's a good chance he's going to get something to handle right here.
And he lays off ball four, so now the potential tying run here is aboard late in the game. And it's fouled away. Fans on their feet in a one-run ball game in the last of the ninth. Staying alive, putting together a really good at bat here. Has them down to their final strike. Here it comes. And it's two balls and two strikes now. Struck him out for out number three. So that'll wrap things up here as they leave the possible tying run stranded at first.
Well, there's another save, but that's just not any other save. That's save number 50 for the reliever in his career. Well on his way to a nice career.
3-2, the finish in tonight's game. Atlanta earned the victory despite only collecting four total hits. Luke Jackson claims the win out of the pen, his first. Will Smith hammers down the save, his first of the year. So that's a wrap here tonight. For Mark DeRosa, Dan Plesac, and Heidi Watney, this is Matt Vaskirjan. You've been watching MLB The Show. For more, find us on Twitter, at MLB The Show.
The final line score for our ball game tonight. For the victorious Atlanta Braves, 3 runs, 4 hits, no error. They left 5 men on base. For the Diamondbacks, 2 runs on 8 hits, no error. They left 11 men on base. Time of the ball game, 2 hours and 56 minutes. Thank you for joining us here tonight. And we remind you to please drive home safely.